competition system. This is where my knees are a little bit shaking because it is a pilot. I did benchmarking with my friends from the research, from the venting, from different countries, and I'm first time showing it to the judgment. So please be nice to me. Otherwise, I'll never show up anymore for my mistake. How we can think about it? I divided the parts of equestrianism, of owning a show sport horse, into three parts. This is the basement, this is the basics, this is what you do when you drive the performance of the horse, yeah? And this, I put it pink because I call it a lipstick stage. It's a luxury stage where you might need it, you might not need it. And if you do not need it, this is wonderful. So what's in here? Number one, stable for comfort and safety. The stable is comfortable, it's safe. Check mark and forget thinking about it. Just forget, because thinking about stable takes it out, takes your attention out of what's important. The horse is fed, nutrition for health and energy. Check mark, out. Goals, to not get stuck in vulnerability zone. This is the topic of this conversation, and I'll cover what it is later. But goals need to be defined. What discipline do you want to be in? Oh, I kind of go with what my horse wants, what it likes, really. That doesn't work like that. You need to know your horse conformation, temperament, physical abilities, your own disposition, what you like. And then set the goals with your trainer. And if you do not have the goals with your trainer, then it is not sport horse owning, it's pensionat living with a, with an animal.
Which one?
Pensionat living. Mm-hmm. Yeah? Then this is not sport. Training, then we move to a performance stage. You need to know your training plan to effectively move to sound performance zone. You need to know budget and discuss your budget with your trainer. Unless you have training plan and budget, there is no point even to having a conversation. You have that, then you select a coach. You might actually have your training plan drafted yourself, and then pick a coach according to your plan. When the horse became available for training, because the horse could be with a breeder, it wasn't sold, it was sold later, breaking started later. So it doesn't matter the age. What does matter is when you start. So from the moment you start, and we're talking about young horse, it is 2 years. Now, what if it is a broodmare and it's being started at 9? There will be the same phases, just for more mature horse when joints already fused and the body got formed, it may take shorter. The duration of each phase will vary from horse to horse, because some of them will go through the first phase quite quickly, and then they will plateau and they will require more time to go through others. For some horses, they will really have a slow start, and they choop, and they're there. Phase A is split in 3 trimesters. I joke that it is like pregnancy. First trimester, second trimester, third trimester. And you have specific exercises and stage of collection, contact in extended outline, debarrage, which is contact in working outline, and then basic connection from behind the horse's hand, balance still on forehand. It equals, by the end of this phase, it equals that the horse is training level tests 1-3 in massage. It equals, but it doesn't mean that the horse should go in a competition in this level. That means that the horse is able to ride the lines of this level in the exercises. For eventing, this part is eventing, this part is dressage. For eventing, it is a beginner novice and a novice test. Then we go phase B, 9 months, and it is first level dressage and it is training and preliminary for eventing. And then we go phase C, second level tests in dressage and intermediary level in and CCI tests in each of these two in eventing. What that means is that this is only indication of the test that the horse might compete. But as you train the horse, you actually use exercises and blueprints from 2 years, from two levels higher. So when you are here, there are dressage exercises, jumping exercises, and cross-country exercises. You use blueprints from this level, from level above, and two levels above. So you can go and show in training level when you actually, your horse can do a simple change and a shoulder in, and the horse can go from the half hold uphill. If you cannot do it, what are you doing in training level? In a competition environment, you have to be able to bring your horse up, even if the trainers will be okay that the horse is on the forehand. But if you want to go 9 and 10, your horse should be not on the forehand, not even a horizontal balance. Your horse should move like Zippity Duda. Who knows this horse? Yeah? That's how your horse should go at the training level. But here we have a confusion. We have a great confusion, and I love very much the Lilo Forer's DVD that I actually brought them to show, that explain levels. But we should not train the horse. I think this is it. Yeah. Who has this DVD? Highly recommend to purchase. It shows everything, the balance, it is so clear. Gary Rockwell, USEFS judge, makes live comments. It is filmed, I believe, in California, or somewhere where it is very warm, because you see nothing. Just dressage arena, sky and horses, it's very beautiful. And it shows all levels from intro to the fourth, from C judge view and from E or B judge view. And they give marks and they give comments and they judge horse, rider. It is a fantastic DVD. I strongly recommend you have it. But this is not, but still the performance of horses at this level is few levels lower than what they require in Europe. And why? Because in Europe they do not train to the level of competition. They train two levels above the competition level. And when they go through the same stages, their horses already in here do much more. They're not being pushed to it, but they're being introduced to it. And decades ago, it was the rule, because equestrianism was business, because it was military and everything. If you do not do a horse, if you do not introduce a horse to Grand Prix movements, full spectrum of Grand Prix movements, within a year, and James Phillips did it within 9 months, you take a thoroughbred off the racetrack, right? 5-year-old horse, you have a year, it's still raw, but the horse should do everything, including one tempest and piaf. If that is not happening, that you are not equipping the horse with the tools and exercises to really perform themselves on that simple training level. I watched on YouTube, there was a Bundes Championat winner in Germany, Chestnut, gorgeous horse, looks like exactly like Zippity Duda, forgot his name. He made a articles everywhere in the world and pretty much became a legend. I watched the state of his go and his gait as he was purchased. No one even looked at that horse. No one wanted to buy that horse. He was so ugly. He moved like a quarter horse, chopping. You know, it was like, it was ridiculous. And then it was a girl who got him to training, and she started training him, and then she competed, and she essentially put him on that horse the full 9 yards. And then she showed him a Bundes championat, and his gates were at the level of the tiller. Yeah, 1 year of training. And they have videos on YouTube how the horse progressed, and it is amazing. From chopping dead on forehand, very heavy in the chest, from this chopping la 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 jogging to this gorgeous zipping, imagine zipping to the dark, yeah, going much greater. It was like absolutely form shaped horse. Fantastic. I wanted to find this video, but I would show it for you. Okay, next please.
Can I ask a question? Yes. Did that horse have the confirmation that this girl could see that he was going to have the ability?
No.
No.
All that happened with that horse was the training that the girl put into him. The horse was ridiculous. But the girl put the training, seriously. The horse, it was lame on one hind leg. It was not, this is probably how she got the horse, yeah? And the horse was not okay and nobody wanted it. Advanced training levels. This is when we start progressing through L, M, and S level all the way to Grand Prix in dressage, and A, finishing A level with advanced in eventing. And CCI, 3 stars and 4 stars, S, A, and B. Correct? Here it takes approximately 9 months here for third and fourth level, and it depends on the horse. This is where most horses get stuck, because some horses do not have mental ability to do high level movements. And all riders, dressage riders, and mental stages know that you can figure it out only when you are on a horse and you see this huge ditch and then this huge wall, yeah, of branches, and then the horse doesn't see that behind the wall there is actually a bank up. And this ditch is huge, it's like 3.5 meters, yeah? And it's 1 meter deep. And so you go, you jump the ditch, and then there is a high thing, and you go phew, over there. Some horses stop, this is too much for them, and there is nothing you can do. You train for 6 years at dressage mount, who is so fantastic in lower levels, but then this horse naturally gets too high in the arousal as you start schooling one tempis. All dressage trainers know, you never know if your horse you buy now will be able to comprehend one tempis. It simply might not. And we're coming back to the fact, because the horse requires maybe not 8 to 9 frames per second. The horse might require 50 frames per second and to perform it. But there is no human being within 100 miles of this area who has this ability. There are a few riders in the world, but there are horses that don't have such riders around them. And frankly, this horse might not be excited enough for that advanced rider to ride him. And so the horse stays at Prison George, maybe I1 level. If it does some massage, it goes to I2, but then it is being sold as a schoolmaster to somebody, yeah, without the issue, young rider. Next.